IVM.
Hi guys, unfortunately we couldn't record a new episode of Know Your Kanoon this week. So instead we are rebroadcasting an earlier episode. We hope you'll enjoy the show. Please listen in.
Hi and welcome to Know Your Kanoon. This is Amber from Corpus Legal. And in our series of next episodes, we are going to cover up the issues pertaining to the MRP, which are faced by us customers and consumers, and the recourse which is available to us against such malpractices by the traders or individuals otherwise, or the restaurants and cineplexes under the Consumer Protection Act, and how we can approach the remedies. Let's take a look at, first of all, to understand the situation of what MRP is. MRP in layman's language is maximum retail price. It is something that is fixed at and beyond which the respective individual or the entity or the, you know, the organization cannot sell that particular price or cannot be priced more than that. But what actually constitutes of an MRP? It involves the basic production cost. It involves the, you know, the minimum profit or any such taxes, etc., which are mentioned and levied by the respective state government, central government. And then it comes up to be the end price. So MRP is 1 plus 2, which is equivalent to 3, which is the ultimate cost which we as consumers bear and pay to the government. Many a times the situations where we, go to certain places and try to buy certain products and we find that there is a huge difference in the price of the product and then what actually we feel should be the legitimate price. Now, the government has made the Legal Metrology Act as the act which defines, you know, the pricing concept, what quantity, what measure, what all other standardized labels, items, etc. should be mentioned on the respective cover of the product or the consumable item and so forth, so on. But how do we actually determine that what is the right price? Now, let's say if the MRP says 20 rupees and we in the market go and the trader or the respective seller says that the price is 32 rupees. Many of us tend to overlook it and we tend to pay 32 rupees, saying that who would argue with such a gentleman and let it be. But in those situations, what we need to see is that he cannot sell, or in many situations that individual cannot sell above the cost of rupees 30, the product at 32. To give you a very common example, which all of us might have faced on airports and similarly on train stations, when we would go, I mean, let's say 4 years, 5 years down the line, we would go to the respective train station and ask for a bottle of Coke while traveling from point A to point B. And the bottle would be priced at rupees 45, 50 by the respective traders or sellers on the station. And we would just end up paying that amount of money and purchase the same. Now, those are the situations that have given rise to these maltrade practices. And many of these situations were also witnessed across many of the, the drinking bars and so forth, so on. So many areas in Mumbai, Delhi, Bangalore, Chennai and so forth, so on. It is due to our ignorance on these matters that these individuals have had the right to do the same. But if we take into consideration the layman, the individuals below poverty line, for them, it is a daily issue to be faced at, even to, pay a rupee more because they calculate it on a monthly basis. And if you look at that, the prices go up of, the cost of living and a major chunk of that is consumable items. Another very common problem which we have faced over the period of time, if you look at in terms of MRPs with the bakers also, and that's been my personal experience, that you go to a certain amount of bakers, they tell you that the frozen items kept by them inside their freezers are priced a little over because they have to maintain the cost of the freezer as well. And in case if you try to get in touch with the parent entity which is selling the respective item through the bakers, they tend to refuse and say, no, that we have not promulgated this price. It is the baker who is doing so. But since it's just a matter of a rupee or 2 rupees, we tend to overlook it. Now, coming to the point, how do we deal with this? What do we do? What redressal do we have? And how do we counter this menace which is around us? To begin with, you'd all be very happy to know that in case you file a consumer complaint, there is a definite way and a measure that you would be getting justice. And in many situations, the court has directed to pay hefty sums, for any such misleading prices as relief. And over and above the amount of, loss which we might have incurred or personal injury that might have happened due to such products. So I insist that each one of us, whoever tries to follow this remedy, should definitely go ahead with it and file a consumer complaint in case he or she feels that, there has been a malpractice along with that particular product which the individual consumed. To enunciate certain examples, where such remedies have come through, let me take you through this. A very good example of another bakery in Pune where the individual was charging rupees 5 or 6 more than the price of a bottle of cola. And, upon asking that, why is the price being charged 4 rupees higher? The owners came back by saying, no, this has been mentioned by the XYZ manufacturing company of the cola that charge a higher price. When we wrote a letter to those guys, they replied back by saying that, no, we are not doing so. And you'd be amazed to see that the district consumer redressal forum, it very clearly said that, any cold drink which is being served can only be served chilled. And the excuse that it has to be kept in a freezer and charged that extra amount of money from the consumer is not valid on part of the service provider. And they were fined a heavy fine, and where they ended up paying ultimately 2,500 rupees for a bottle of cola, which was hardly worth 10 rupees. And so forth, so on. There are so many examples, like in temples or otherwise, where the district redressal forum, dispute forum has come forward and helped out individuals. So coming on to the issue, how do we approach the forum, and what do we do about in case an MRP has been charged to us, which is not right? Complaint for, under the Consumer Protection Act, or in case of a redressal for wrongful MRP being charged, can be made in writing under the following list of circumstances. Firstly, where there has been any loss or damage which has been caused to us consumers due to any unfair or restrictive trade practice by a trade or a service provider. Secondly, in case the article which was purchased by us is defective. Thirdly, in a situation where services which have been availed by a consumer suffer from any deficiency. Now, deficiency is again interpretive. Fourthly, in case where a trader or a service provider, as the case may be, has charged for the goods or the services mentioned in the complaint a price in excess of the stipulated price. And lastly, for goods and services which will be hazardous to life and safety when used or being offered for sale to the public. Now, in all of these situations, what has to be seen is that there has to be a contract of service, and you have to be classified as a consumer, and any of the violations which fall should be within one of these clauses which have been mentioned here. Only then can you file a consumer complaint. Now, coming to the point of who is eligible to file such a complaint. Such a complaint can be filed by any consumer, any voluntary consumer association, central government, state government. In case there's a body of consumers, then one or more consumers. In case there are multiple consumers having same interest, all of them collectively can file the same. In case during the proceedings, or in case when the service was being provided which was deficient, there is death of the consumer, then his or her legal heirs can also file the respective case for consumer relief. Coming to the point of where to file a complaint. Now, as per Consumer Protection Act 1986, a complaint can be filed based on two things. That is the pecuniary jurisdiction, which determines the amount, which defines the circle where a complaint has to be filed, and the territory, which determines where the offense was committed or where the grievance has happened, and which authority is in charge in that area to deal with that. So the first and foremost, the lowest form of authority is the District Consumer Disputes Redressal Forum, where the value of the claim is up to rupees 20 lakhs and it can be filed there. The next is the State Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission, where in case the value of the claim exceeds rupees 20 lakhs but is within 1 crore, the redressal can be filed. Third and lastly is the National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission, if the value of the claim exceeds 1 crore. Howsoever, in case either of the three, the situation does not get settled at the redressal forums, then we have the right to approach the Supreme Court, that is by way of appeal. And starting from the lowest, authority, which is the district court, we can appeal to the state, then to the national, and as I mentioned, to the Supreme Court. Howsoever, the appeal in each of the cases has to be filed within 30 days of the order. Now I'll come to the point of how to file the complaint with Consumer Forum. You can file the complaint on a plain paper. Stamp paper is not a mandatory requirement for declaration. It should contain the details of complainant and the opposite party. The complaint can be registered in person by the complainant or through his authorized agent or by post address to the redressal agency. It is not at all compulsory for us to engage a lawyer to file a complaint in the situations. The fees charged are very nominal according to the value of the claim which is mentioned. In most of these consumer complaint cases, the individual can himself to represent himself in the court or in the redressal forums. All you need to do is to mention in the complaint the following details. The details which you need to furnish in the complaint form are as follows. You need to mention the name and complete address of the complainant, name and the complete address of the opposite parties, date of purchase of goods or services which have been availed, the amount which has been paid for the above purposes, particulars of goods purchased with numbers or details of services availed, details of the complaint whether it is against unfair trade practices, supply of defective goods, deficiency in service provided, collection of excess price. All of these should be explicitly and detailed mentioned in the complaint petition. Bills and receipts and copies of connected correspondence in case if any. The relief sought for under this act and the complaint should be signed by the complainant or his authorized agent. Prescribed time period for filing a complaint in the consumer forum. Generally, you'll have to file the complaint within 2 years from the date of cause of the action, or, you know, the deficiency in service or defect in goods, so forth, so on. However, the limitation of time does not apply in situations, and you can go and file the complaint after 2 years also, in case you have reasonable grounds which satisfy the respective forums that, you know, why you could not file the respective case for 2 years. But it's a very thorough suggestion that it should be filed within the period of 2 years of availment of service, or where the deficiency of service has happened or deficiency in goods has happened. Of the activism and by the push through the government, you know, for consumer redressals and consumer helplines being functional, you would be amazed to know that recently in 2018, there was a judgment where in case and also promulgated by the central government where, you know, when we go to cinema halls, you know, how exorbitant the pricings are of consumable items. A direction was passed mentioning and telling all cinema hall owners that, you know, there will be a menu which will be displayed with the correct MRPs of the items which are, you know, packed eatables. So to give you an example, a packet of chips, nachos or cold drinks which are packed can only be sold at MRP prices and not above and beyond them. Also, what is interesting to see is the government is fighting and has pushed for an agenda where eatables from outside can also be allowed to enter the cinema hall, on which there is a lot to and fro going on, as cinema hall owners make majority of their money through this process. And then we all have been a victim and a party to it, where we end up paying at least 3 to 4 times the more cost of what would generally be pretty less outside of a consumable item. So the new directive from the central government also envisages and says that, you know, elderlies, kids and patients can take their own food inside the halls and they cannot be stopped. So any octogenarian, any senior citizen, a kid and a respective patient suffering any ailment can respectively take their food from their home and enter the cinema halls. This is for all you guys as a part of the awareness. They cannot be restricted from having that those items within the halls. In case such a situation arises where you are defied to enter, please follow recourse and approach the district consumer, you know, council or addressal forum, as I've previously mentioned, the process for approaching the same, because the cinema halls cannot stop you from doing that. Some practical situations and judgments, again, as I previously mentioned in the beginning, I would like to highlight to your cause where, you know, the awareness of the citizens helped stop this illegal practice. And one of them is, I would not name the individual, I would say Mr. X. I had gone to a liquor shop to procure a particular brand of whiskey, and the MRP of the whiskey was, let's say, $1,000. But Mr. X was charged an amount which was 111 rupees higher. So let's say at $1,160. Upon his complaint, the shop's owner at that point of time and the staff told him that, you know, this is the renewed price which has been mentioned. But since you're looking at the old stock, you would not know what the price is. Howsoever, Mr. X went to the respective redressal forum, and you would be amazed to know that a notice was sent. And it was a very serious offense as upheld by the district forum. Mr. X was granted a compensation of 10,000, and 2,000 rupees was charged by the redressal forum from the liquor shop by saying as court costs. So, and also to your amazement, you would be amazed to know that in the end, the court also further said, in case the individual does not make those payments within the stipulated time of 1 month, then they would be imprisoned for 7 years. Now, that's a very, very harsh, you know, judgment there. But what is interesting to see is that definitely if we approach the right consumer forum, there are definitive measures. And I would like to thank Mr. X for creating this awareness in citizens. Another very interesting case, I'll tell you, it's not a matter about 1 rupee or 100 rupees or 15 rupees. Everything which is illegal is accountable in the eyes of law, provided we follow the right recourse. Now, here in this situation, there's another gentleman, and I would name him as Mr. Y, where he had gone to purchase 2 bottles of water, all right, from one of the water stations on the road, which you find like a normal retailer or a trader. The individual charged just rupees 1.5 extra. That would say that the bottle costed rupees 10 and Mr. Y had to pay 11.50 rupees. And on account of which, when Mr. Y asked for a bill and so forth, so on from a trader, he refused to provide them. And he insisted on saying that, you know, give me some kind of evidence. It was denied at all costs. And he said, why are you charging me extra than the MRP? They said, this is what the new cost is. Mr. Y approached the district redressal forum in Mumbai, went to the respective individuals and filed a case against the bottling company saying that, you know, you are selling your products at this price. The forum took it upon themselves, held the person accountable, which was the trader, rather than the bottling company, as they issued a statement saying that we do not promote such practices. And rupees 20,000 was provided as a compensation for the suffering which Mr. Y had to face. So imagine a bottle which would cost rupees 10. The traders had to end up paying rupees 20,000. So, these are situations where we need to bring in consumer awareness. So, even if it's a matter of rupees 1 or rupees 2, please do not let these guys sell such products at illegal cost, because it's detrimental to the society, it's detrimental to us, and we are denying our own rights chartered under the Constitution.
Thank you for listening to Know Your Kanoon. For more queries and questions, please contact me at contact@corpuslegal.in. Catch Know Your Kanoon every week on the IVM website or the app or anywhere you get your podcast from.
Hey Meghna, do you know how to citizen?
Hey Shreyas, do you know how to citizen?
Hey Meghna, do you know how to citizen?
Hey Shreyas, let's just do a podcast about it.
Let's do a podcast about it. A podcast is called How to Citizen. In every episode, we get a new guest and discuss one chapter from the 8th grade civics textbook. Think about it as three friends revising before a test, and we go back to school. There's nostalgia, there's trauma, there are lunch breaks, there are favorite teachers, there are horrible teachers, there's everything.
So every Tuesday, we bring in a guest on the podcast and we ask them a very simple question. Do you know how to citizen?
Meghnad, I think the question is, do you know how to citizen?
But Shreyas, I'm asking you this question. Do you know how to citizen?
Filter coffee is a fascinating beverage. You need to pick the right beans, blend them in the right proportion, roast them to perfection, and slow brew at the right temperature to get the perfect cup. Which is exactly like great conversations as well. You need to track down the most interesting minds, get them into their zone, and settle down for an unhurried, unscripted chat. And coffee for me is always, always, always best enjoyed with friends. I'm Karthik Nagarajan, and do share my table as I meet some of the most interesting people I know and sit them down for a strong cup of coffee and an even stronger conversation. Join me every Wednesday for a freshly brewed episode. This is not Frappe. This is the Filter Coffee Podcast.